all the planes we flew, good things we've been through, then I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. See you in a better place. Can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I would do, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I see you again.
We've come a long way,
yeah, we came a long way
from where we began.
You know, we started.
Oh, I'll tell you all about it. See you again.
I tell you
when I see you again.
You both go out your way and the vibe is feeling strong. It was small, turn to a friendship turn to a bond, and that bond will never be broken, the love will never get lost. And when brotherhood come first, then the line will never be crossed. Established it on our own when that line had to be drawn, and that line is what we reach. So remember me when I'm gone. Can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you're gonna be with me for the last ride.
So let the light guide your way. Yeah. Hold every memory as you go. And every road you take. Without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you.
Gaming. Here we go. Thank you. push down the bass drum music stand. I'm worried it's going to blow the way it is right now. Just push it down.
Thank you. quickly, guys, real quickly. Here we go. Here we go. Starts with clicks. Three, one, two, here we go.
Thank you.
processional. My trumpets, here we go.
Thank you. All right, thank you, graduates. Have a seat. Good morning, everyone. My name is Gracie Taylor, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to the Whiteland Community High School graduation for the class of 2022. Would everyone please stand and join me in saying the Pledge of Allegiance and National Anthem? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. To begin our program, I would like to introduce Tara Watson for some opening remarks.
You guys look good. Each and every year, there's a senior class that makes an impact on the school when they leave. Each year, there are teachers who have to part ways with students that they watch grow up for 4 years into young adults. Although many teachers will have to go through this routine once again this year, the class of 2022 is a special one. Not only did the class overcome obstacles such as online school, hybrid schedules, and quarantining, but we did it while making a countless amount of unforgettable memories. I remember coming into the high school for freshman orientation, and I was just like, bruh. It was overwhelming. I mean, who knew there could be more than 3 main hallways in a school? I'm sure that many of you felt the same way when it first coming to the high school, and sure, we can laugh about it now, but back then, it was definitely not a laughing matter. As freshman year went on and we started to figure things out, it was wonderful, and frankly, it was very normal. Perfect, almost. But then sophomore year came, and then we were all like, bruh, like, again. We had to put our freshman mindset behind and quickly step up to the real world. We got to experience football games in the middle of the student section instead of the back, and we got to walk the halls feeling much more comfortable. We danced the night away at homecoming and waved at teachers we knew from the year before. Everything was getting good, great even, but then it hit, COVID. At first, we all took it lightly and were just excited to have some extra weeks off of school, but then it began to start affecting us and the people around us. We were forced to grow up quickly and make decisions about where we go and who we see. It started to feel lonely, and it was not an easy time for us as students. If I would have known a little bit earlier that our grades didn't actually count against us at that time, it probably would have been a little bit easier, but that is in the past. Although I wish I could say that junior year went back to normal and everyone got the perfect education that they had hoped for, I unfortunately cannot. Junior year was definitely rough for us as a class. Going to school sometimes, staying home other times, missing 2 weeks of school because you're not feeling well. It was not easy to keep up with school and focus when your bed is 2 feet away. But hey, at least we got to play Jenga at prom. Towards the end of junior year, things started to feel normal again. #we love our healthcare workers. and we got to go into this year with a fresh start, almost. And although things have changed quite a bit, we adapted and overcame all of the hard times that we had to go through. And we did it together. This year has been emotional, exciting, and full of firsts and lasts, and there's no one I would have rather spent it with than the people sitting in front of me today. The class of 2022 has been through it all, and in all honesty, there is no other way I would rather have it. We have learned so much from each and every obstacle we have encountered, and that is what high school is really about. The people sitting in front of me right now today are the future, and I promise you there is no one better to trust with the future in their hands than this class. We have done amazing things, and we'll continue to do so in whatever we take on in the next years of our lives. I would now like to take a moment and leave my classmates with the wise words of DaBaby in his feature, Levitating with Dua Lipa. Get your bread up. Students, please continue to be yourselves and get your bread up. I know there are a lot of hustlers in this class, so that should not be an issue. I think I'm supposed to say our actual senior quote now, though, so I'm going to do that. Our lives before us, our past behind us, but our memories are forever with us. Thank you, class of 2022, for being not only my peers, but my friends and my family. I will forever cherish the memories we have together, and I hope you will too. Now it is my honor to welcome our principal, Mr. Benji Betts.
Good morning, and welcome to the graduation ceremony of the class of 2022. On behalf of the graduates, I would like to thank you for joining us today to share in this celebration. This ceremony is the culmination of many years of hard work, and for this group of students, patience. Today, that hard work and patience will be rewarded with a high school diploma. Students, congratulations for being here this morning. I wish you all well in your future endeavors, and remember, you should always be proud that you're a warrior. As we begin our program this morning, please allow me to introduce the individuals who are seated on the stage with us. Please stand as you are introduced. I ask the audience to please hold your applause until everyone on the stage has been introduced. On my right, Mr. Butch Zeich, School Board President. Mr. David Thompson, School Board Vice President. Board members, Mrs. Kimberly Crawford and Mr. Craig Cook. Our Superintendent, Dr. Patrick Spray. Our Director of Human Resources, Dr. John Schlosky. Mr. Duke Lines, Assistant Principal. Mr. Brent Holman, Assistant Principal. Seated to my left, Robert R.J. McCoy, Valedictorian. Monpreet Kara, Salutatorian. Lydia Lukic, Salutatorian. Gracie Taylor, Class of 2022 Treasurer. Grace Molesky, Class of 2022 Secretary. Jenna Kelsey, Class of 2022 Vice President. And Tara Watson, Class of 2022 President. Please help me welcome these individuals and congratulate all of our students. You may be seated. It is now my sincere pleasure to introduce to you the Vice President for the Class of 2022, Jenna Kelsey.
Today is a day to celebrate. All of the hard work, time, and tears put into these diplomas is something to be proud of. But that diploma wouldn't be possible without the hard work, time, and tears from our amazing teachers. WCHS teachers have devoted countless hours to each and every one of us and have helped shape us into the people we are today. While Whiteland Community High School has many deserving educators, there is one the class of 2022 would like to recognize today. I am honored to represent my class in presenting the 2022 Teacher of the Year Award. Even in his short 5 years of teaching here at WCHS, his passion and dedication to each of his students is the reason he's being recognized today. He constantly provided a fun and positive environment in his classroom and built a community instead of a class. Every student was cared for individually, and each was treated with respect. His care for each student that walked through his door was evident, and the reason we wanted to succeed. This dedication was not only limited to his classroom, but was spread throughout our school and community. As the advisor of both Spanish Honor Society and the International Culture Club, his passion for education and other cultures has created such a community at our school. Through these opportunities, he has provided countless experiences to WCHS students to try new things and learn about others. His efforts have made a difference here at WCHS and have really created the community in Whiteland Community High School. This teacher is deeply appreciated by all of his students, fellow educators, the community, and everyone here at WCHS. We appreciate his dedication, selflessness, and passion for every student here at Whiteland Community High School. The class of 2022 has the utmost honor of presenting the Teacher of the Year Award to Señor Mizraim Lorenzo Aguilar. Señor Aguilar, please make your way to the stage at this time. I'd like to take a brief moment to read the inscription on the plaque. Teacher of the Year Award, presented to Señor Aguilar for your caring, for love and tenderness, your patience and generosity, and boundless thoughtfulness. You imprint lives forever in the hearts of grateful students. With love, Class of 2022. It is now my pleasure to introduce your senior class secretary, Ms. Grace Molesky, who will be presenting the Holly Harlow Award.
This year, it is my pleasure to present the Live for Today Holly Harlow Award. Ms. Holly Harlow was a WCHS graduate, cheerleader, and salutatorian of her class. She was also a well-loved math teacher at Whiteland Community High School. Ms. Harlow inspired others as a classmate, a colleague, and a mentor prior to and during her 10-year battle with cancer. Ms. Harlow passed away during the 2006-2007 school year. Today, as we honor her memory with this award, we continue to remember what an inspiration she is. Staff, students, and community members were encouraged to nominate individuals that exemplify Ms. Harlow's character. At this time, I am pleased to honor Todd Croy as the 2022 Holly Harlow Award winner. Mr. Croy has worked at Whiteland Community High School for 28 years. During this time, he had numerous roles, including being a science teacher for middle school and high school, a coach for football, basketball, softball, and baseball, and an assistant athletic director. Throughout these different positions, one thing still remained the same: his commitment to the school, his coworkers, and the students. During my 4 years at WCHS, I've had the privilege of having Mr. Croy as my assistant athletic director and as my coordinator for the Athletic Leadership Council. I'm so glad I've had this experience. He has always been willing to work with me and any other student that came to him with an idea. Even though he has so many responsibilities, he was always willing to meet with me at any time to plan something or to just talk about life. Mr. Croy has been seen to go the extra mile to assist his school and community. It is evident that although Mr. Croy did not grow up in Whiteland, he has made a home and a community here. I can't think of anyone else more deserving of this award. Kelly Goff, Holly's sister, and Ashlyn McCammon, Holly's niece, will now present this award. Please welcome Todd Croy, Kelly Goff, and Ashlyn McCammon as they make their way to the stage. It is my pleasure to introduce the WCHS Band and Choir. Senior band and choir members, please come to the stage now.
At this time, it is my honor to introduce you to our salutatorian, Lydia Lukic. Lydia, congratulations on this accomplishment and the hard work that it has taken you to get here today.
In season 2, episode 23 of Grey's Anatomy, there was a patient who built his career and his life on playing the violin. It was what he loved to do more than anything. When asked how he reached his success, he said, "What I lack in natural ability, I make up for in discipline. I'm not the most talented, nor am I the brightest, but I will be the best." His words made me realize that talent does not necessarily predispose you to your achievements, nor does a lack of talent stop you. Behind every achievement is the strength and dedication that's difficult for others to see. Getting into more of what I want to talk about today, the way I see it, in some ways, people are a bit like trees. When trees grow, we only see the beauty of the branches and leaves above ground. What we don't see are the roots and inner layers, much like when we look at people, we see the beauty of their success, but we are blind to the practice and challenges they had to overcome to get there. Trees take hundreds, sometimes thousands of years to reach their heights we see today. High school may not have taken 1,000 years, despite what it seemed like, but each of us has grown significantly since we began. These 4 years changed kind of like the seasons did. Freshman year was like summer. We were so happy to be free from middle school, eager to have fun and not take classes seriously. That was the year of the hydro flask, if you remember, not being able to walk into a classroom without seeing at least 10 girls with one on their desk. Remember when our most pressing concern was saving the turtles by using metal straws? Yeah, that was a simpler time. Then came sophomore year, like the season of fall, when we settled into high school and became more comfortable. This was a year of drastic change. Many of us began driving, discovering what we're passionate about, and of course, the change that no one saw coming, the COVID-19 pandemic arrived. Fast forward to junior year, that was one long winter. We weren't sure if high school would ever end. Difficult classes deprived us of energy. Sometimes I would log onto a Google Meet for a class from home just to take a nap, as long as my mic and camera were off, of course. It was hard to stay motivated, but
We survived and held on until the leaves came back and things were green again. Finally, senior year was like springtime. We could visualize the new beginnings. We grew more vibrant and unique than ever, ready for the future ahead of us. Another thing about trees, like us, they cannot exist alone. They depend on their environment to truly thrive. Likewise, I could not have gone here as the person I am without my parents, who I would love to thank today. Right now, I'll just talk about my dad, since you probably know him as Mr. Lukic. Hi, Dad. Thank you for never giving up on teaching calculus to your students, especially me, and even teaching when you had COVID. I always get asked what it's like having a teacher who's also my dad. So I'll say he's the kind of dad that, when I was barely old enough to talk, he would take me to Summerfield Park and push me on the swings. The catch was that I had to count every single push correctly, or else he would stop and start over. So you'd see moms at the park kind of smile when I counted to 10, act pretty impressed when I could count past 20 or 30, but by the time I got to the triple digits, they would just roll their eyes and walk away. As children, not only do we depend on our parents or whoever takes care of us, we see them as superheroes and often strive to share their better qualities. To me, one of my dad's superpowers is his understanding of calculus that had me baffled for years. Now, after taking Calc BC, I can use things like series and Euler's method, which he probably doesn't even remember how to do. The point is, we've all learned a lot since we were kids, and it's all thanks to the people who nurtured and taught us so we could grow on our own, much like how trees need the sunlight to grow. There are obvious differences, though, between us and the trees. We aren't stuck in one place in the ground. High school taught me that we can learn and do anything. You can bend the rules when you want to. You can pick up a violin, a Scrabble dictionary, or even a ping pong paddle. You really can change your life into whatever you want it to be. What doesn't change is our roots. There's no such thing as starting over. Seasons will keep repeating, but they will look different for all of us next time around as we transition into new phases of our lives. It won't always be easy. At times, you'll feel as though someone has cut you down until there's nothing left. I ask you to trust that things will get green again, even in the harsh winters. There's so much in nature that's temporary that we don't have control over. But if you focus on the things you do have control over, such as the strength and dedication that led to your graduation today, you will grow more beautiful than ever and reach heights you never knew were possible.
Thank you, Lydia. Next, it is my honor to introduce our co-salutatorian. We're fortunate to have two this year, Manpreet Kara. Manpreet, congratulations on this accomplishment and all of the hard work that it has taken for you to get here today. Manpreet Kara.
We're at the crossroads yet again. A few years ago, we stood nervous and excited at the crossroads of eighth grade and high school. Though we did glance back at our taken path with its days filled with the innocence of childhood, Minecraft, and embarrassing selfies, we looked forward to the path in front of us. We scrambled through the halls during freshman orientation with our schedules clutched tight in our hands, hoping that we'd learn where our classes were before the first day of school. You know, just so we didn't look like newbie freshmen to the much more experienced upperclassmen. Now, we stand at the crossroads of high school and life with the same nervousness and excitement we had a few years ago. Today, we sit and glance back at our old path filled with memories. The Friday football games with our closest friends, where we screamed only when the crowd did. The pre-COVID pep rallies, where our main goal was to defeat the seniors, who always seemed to somehow win each year. And the time that we embarrassingly slipped in the snow in front of everyone. Okay, maybe the last one was just me, but today we sit and glance back at our memories. Tomorrow, we look forward to the path in front of us, life. Though this path can be rocky at times, it's filled with endless possibilities. At some points in history, there was a time where each one of us would have been completely barred from opportunity. In the 1200s, it was because we weren't the upper class elites. In the 1800s, it was because some of us were people of color. And in the 1900s, it was because some of us were women. Today, on this June 4th of 2022, we stand in a world with more opportunities than ever before. A world with more acceptance. A world where we hear success stories of those like us. And a world where people like me can stand up here and speak to you all. This world, though not perfect, is shaped by the generations of men and women before us who carved these paths for us. It is shaped by everyday people like my parents, who I'd like to thank right now. My dad, who was and still is my superhero. Throughout your life, you've never been afraid of working for greater causes. When you immigrated to the United States, you worked for a better future for your family. When you joined the army, you worked for a better country. Whenever you've done anything, you've worked for a better tomorrow for us all. You taught me that I shouldn't be ashamed of trying. My mom, who is my biggest supporter, you're always there to listen to my long rants before I even let you leave your car after work. You always somehow know when I'm feeling down, and you always know what to say. You've shown me that love means more in our actions than our words. Just like my parents, many of our families, friends, teachers, and administrators, and more before them, are part of these generations. We shouldn't forget their efforts, but more importantly, we shouldn't forget ours. You've worked hard, made sacrifices. Some of you showed up to school fighting your inner demons hidden behind a smile. You got up out of bed on the darkest days where there seemed to be no light at the end of the tunnel. You did all of that without any recognition or awards. You got here today. You got here because you always looked ahead to the path in front of you, even though it was easier going back. In life, you'll face similar crossroads where you'll have to make the great decision whether to turn back or to keep going, to keep searching for your happiness, to keep reaching out for your dreams. Former First Lady Eleanor Roosevelt had once said, "Today is the oldest you've ever been and the youngest you'll ever be again." We're wise enough to learn from our old paths, but we shouldn't be consumed by them. We must forgive ourselves so we can be our best selves. I hope you choose to look ahead and keep going. We shouldn't take our opportunities for granted. We shouldn't take life for granted. And most importantly, class of 2022, we shouldn't take ourselves for granted.
And now it is my honor to introduce you to our valedictorian, Robert R.J. McCoy. R.J., congratulations on your accomplishments as well, and all of the hard work and dedication that it has taken you to get here today. R.J. McCoy.
Thank you for the introduction, Mr. Betts. Ladies and gentlemen, I proudly stand before you all today as the Whiteland valedictorian for the class of 2022. But before I begin with the main part of my speech, I would like to very briefly thank the people who have helped shape who I am today. First and foremost, I would like to thank the Lord my God for the comfort and strength that he has shown me and the truth that he has given me throughout my life. He has stood with me. Thank you. He has stood with me through every exam I've taken, every challenge I've faced, and every mistake I've made. Even now, as I stand up here amongst you all, shaking in my VeggieTales shoes, which are technically in compliance with the dress code, I feel his comforting, guiding hand on my shoulder, helping me through every word that I speak. Secondly, I would like to thank my family for their continuous support in me. They have taught me so many valuable life lessons, and I am so grateful for having such a wonderful, loving family. My special shout-outs go to my brothers John and Andrew McCoy for being the best brothers I could ask for. Next, I would like to thank the many friends that I made along the way. Thank you all for putting up with my childish antics and my insane ramblings. My special thanks goes to my dear friends Ethan Collins, Maya Adkins, and Bibi. You know who you are. Thank you three specifically for being the best friends that I could have asked for. And finally, I would like to thank the fine administration here at Whiteland for the roles that they have played in our lives. Specifically for me, that of Mr. Brian Cuches and Mr. Tim Fish for setting me on my career path and improving my love for math. Again, thank you everyone for shaping who I am today. Without you, I would most likely not be here. Now, on to the meat of my speech. Ladies and gentlemen, for those of you unaware, I graduated a semester early. Having finished high school, it was my intent to kick back and relax for a couple months before I was off to college. Now, during this time, I did what any 18-year-old boy would do. I started studying the philosophical works of the great Athenian thinkers, specifically that of Socrates. And what fascinated me the most about him was how he had pursued truth. You see, Socrates, he would seek truth by questioning everyone and everything, paving the way for what we now call the Socratic method. However, it was this method that ultimately led to his death. You see, the people hated Socrates. They hated him because they feared him. They feared how his logical arguments had caused them to question their own beliefs. You see, this fear of Socrates grew to the point where they falsely tried him for impiety against the gods of the state and corrupting the minds of the youth. All Socrates had wanted to do was pursue truth and share with others the wisdom he had gained along the way. So why then would people be afraid of him? Why would they fear what Socrates had tried to show them? Well, to answer that question, we must first understand what happens when we as individuals are presented with the truth. We will most often do one of three things. Either we will hide or ignore it, refuse to seek it ourselves any further, or the hardest of the three, we will accept reality for what it is and pursue that relationship with the truth. Now, first, when we hide from truth, we are hiding from reality. We become so tired of the hands that we are dealt that we seek ways of escape. For some, it might be substance abuse. For others, it might simply be living in a fantasy world. The harsh truth is that we crave addiction in order to make our lives more tolerable. A lot of the time that I spent these last 2 months on my break was spent playing video games. To me, video games were a way to escape into a virtual world where I could live any life that I had wanted to live. If I wanted adventure, I'd play games like The Witcher or Red Dead Redemption. If I wanted action, I'd play games like Call of Duty or Battlefield. However, it got to the point where I'd spend 8 or more hours a day playing these games. One day, I realized why I was playing these games so often, and I realized that I was hiding. I created this virtual world for myself to run and hide to instead of accepting the responsibilities that life had given me. After this realization, I decided I'd start a 3-week-long fast in which I did not play nor watch any media. This fast helped me to think more clearly, more logically, more reasonably, and helped me to better fortify myself against my own addictions. Now, I want to make it clear that there's nothing wrong with having a hobby that allows for a brief break from the world, but it is when we would rather participate in our diversions than deal with the responsibilities that life has for us that they can become a negative. You see, when we hide in our addictions, we hide from reality, and when we're hiding from reality, we are ignoring truth. Another choice we have when we are presented with the truth is refusing to seek it. Now, normally, when we refuse to seek truth, we become complacent in the degree of which we understand the world. We think that because we already know everything, there is nothing left to discover. However, the truth of the matter is none of us will ever truly know everything. One of Socrates' most famous quotes is that true wisdom lies in knowing that we know nothing. We human beings have limits to our knowledge. There are some questions we cannot answer simply because we do not know, nor likely will we ever. However, there will be people in our life who tell us they know all the answers. Fun fact, they don't. They simply provide their perspectives that are based on their own life experiences. It is up to us to question our beliefs and make sure that they are reasonable, sound, logical, and cross-examine them. And then when we think we're done cross-examining our beliefs, we do it again, and then with every new bit of information we gain along the way, we cross-examine our beliefs again. See, we should never stop questioning our beliefs and our ideas, because pursuing truth is one of the most important actions we can take as people. And while it is unlikely that we'll ever truly know the answers to life's biggest questions, we must still pursue. So, in review, some of us choose to hide or ignore truth, others will remain stagnant in their beliefs. We cannot be trapped by these pitfalls. We must choose a third choice. We must accept reality for what it is, for all the good, for all the evil, for all the unfairness, and push through it and pursue that relationship with the truth. So as we embark on the next part of our lives, I encourage everyone here to stop hiding, stop ignoring, stop refusing your call to truth, and pursue that which will ultimately bring us inner peace. Because as the old adage says, the truth is what will set us free. Congratulations, class of 2022, and thank you.
Just before we get our diplomas, I would like to take a moment to acknowledge our classmates that were unable to join us today. Students, as we celebrate a big milestone in our lives, we also mourn the loss of four students that were supposed to be here with us. If you take a look to my left, you will see four empty chairs in the front row to honor our friends. At this time, I ask that we please take a moment of silence to commemorate these students. You will notice graduates of the class are wearing ribbons and bracelets so we can carry our friends with us across the stage today. Although these materials will never amount to the happy souls we have lost, it is an honor to see their legacies carry on. As our bracelet says, you are always loved, never forgotten, and forever missed.
Before we present the class of 2022, I'd like to thank the families of Abdullah, Ryan, Dakota, and Mason for being here with us today. Before I present the graduates, I would like to point out those individuals in this graduating class who are wearing honors diplomas. These students have earned an academic honors diploma, a technical honors diploma, or both. Would those students please stand to be recognized? You may be seated. Next, I would like to recognize those students who are wearing honor cords. During their high school careers, these students have been part of a service organization and or an honor society. Would those students please stand to be recognized? Thank you, you may be seated. And finally, in the class of 2022, we have a number of students who will be entering military service, and one student, ETA Connor Ridlin, that is not here today because of his military obligations. We ask that students going into the military service and any service members that are in attendance in the crowd today, please stand to be recognized. On behalf of Whiteland Community High School, we thank you all for your service. Please be seated. Parents and guests, it is now time to present the class of 2022. As we do so, students will come to the stage to be recognized by row. At the end of each row, There will be time to applaud and celebrate for each for the students. As your student crosses the stage, please refrain from individual celebrations as the student names are announced so that the next student's name can be heard by their family as well. Thank you for respecting the wishes of our students and us as we celebrate their graduation. Members of the Clark Pleasant Community School Corporation Board of Education and Central Office Administration, on behalf of the faculty and staff at Whiteland Community High School, I certify that the members of the class of 2022 have fulfilled the requirements for graduation as prescribed by the Department of Education for the state of Indiana and the Clark Pleasant School Board. Therefore, it is my recommendation that these students be granted diplomas as evidence of their graduation. Would the first row please stand?
Robert R.J. McCoy. Manpreet Kara. Lydia Catherine Lukic. Jenna Ruth Kelsey. Grace Elizabeth Molesky. Cecilia Grace Taylor. Tara Elizabeth Watson. Daniel Robert Adams. Cameron Marcus Adwell. Zachary Eugene Ahmed. Ashlyn Annette May Akers. Roxanne Dawn Allen. Alexander Thomas Applegate. Avery Ryan Arthur. Caitlin Marie Ash. Brenna Nicole Atchison. Kun Tu Ong. Jaskarn Singh Baines. Molly Sue Winlin Baker. Langston Elias Baldwin. Yushindi Banga. Derek Nicholas Barnd. Andrew Riley Barnes. Lily Elizabeth Barnhorst. Mason Jane Barrett. Gabriella Lee Bartek. Owen Milo Bartuszek. Tino Keith Beaver. Hannah K. Beecraft. Lexi Elizabeth Bean. Emily Grace Beresford. Nazaya Ashe Bethay. Dashan Singh Bular. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of the stage in row one. Samuel James Billingsley. Troy Nicholas Bishop. Henry Eric Arthur Black. Kyler Joseph Black. Connor James Bolts. Trinity McKay Borders. Riley Ann Bowling. Alexia Taylor Bowman. Victoria Elizabeth Bowman. Kyle Lee Brady. Aaliyah Marie Brewer. Andrew Stephen Brown. Connor James Buchkowski. Amelia Annette Bunch. Paul Daniel Burgess. Christian Tobias Bush. Connor Matthew Buteau. Annabella Rose Kane. Luke Matthew Kane. Elian Adriel Camacho Ortiz. Lal Catherine. Jackson Lee Cottle. Harmon Chahal. Manroop Chahal. Andrew James Chapella. Kima Chongthu. Edward James Sibulskis. Nicandro Cisneros. Noah Stone McKinney Claxton. Chloe Marie Clements. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of Row 2. Braylon Lily Clendenin, Mackenzie Jane Clevenger, Caitlin Ann Clip, Brooklyn Paige Cole, Anaya Lachey Coleman, Nina Nicole Colvin, Sophia Larray Copeland, Jacob Reed Copes, Ellen Jane Coriel, Emma Paris Couch, Alan Everett Cox, Courtney Shea Cox, Landon Nathan James Cox, Carly Danielle Cravens, Bryce Davin Cross, Jaden Renee Crouch, Alyssa Ellen Cullens, Kelsey Renee Cummings, Ariana Trinice Curtis, Aurora Marie Curtis, Keaton Christopher Dager, Emma Elizabeth Daly, Christian Anthony Darby, Jedrick Dante Davila, Ashley Paige Davis, Audrey Christine Davis, Connor Robert Davis, Luca Theon Davis, Micaiah Tanay Davis, Michael Allen Davis. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of Row 3. William A. Davis, William D. Davis, Grace Angelique Day, Cheyenne Renee Deaton, Hannah Elizabeth DiBernardi, Devin Alexa DeGrassi, Benjamin Thomas DeWeese, Gracie Irene DeWitt, Arshpreet Carr Dillon, Yash Dillon, Emily Elizabeth Dick, Brandon Andrew Dobbs, Cooper Michael Drake, Logan Benjamin Dudek, Michael James Donovan, Sarah Michelle Dunlavy, Abigail H. Eads, Tiberius Travail Edwards, Mark Bradley Ellis, Jose Louis Espinoza. Jada Nicole Evans. Nathaniel Lee Everidge. Audrey Laura Ray Fagan. Chloe Alexandria Farr. Nolan Richard Ferguson. Riley Scott Ferguson. Sarah Maylin Fillmore. Kyle Brian Foster. Elijah Wesley Joseph France. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of row 4. Matthew Lee Fravel, Jaden Gallardo, Nicholas Ray Gallion, Adam Thomas Gergis, Alexandria Lee Gaskell, Griffin H. Gentry, Muskan K. Guman, Mason Alexander Giddens, Olivia Grace Giesking, Bhavjeet Singh Gill, Karnveer S. Gill, Riley Jade Gibson, Griffin Cade Goble, Kaya Elizabeth Godar, David Gonzalez Carmona, Cooper Donley Gordon, Jordan Alyssa Gottschalk, Dylan James Gorley, Corbin Douglas Grantham, Ava James Green, Noah Michael Green, Chad Lewis Gregory, Levi James Gregory, Lynanne Elizabeth Gressmeyer, Carly Nicole Griffiths, Michael Dylan Gross, Kyan Ray Hamilton, Paige Nicole Hardacre, Dalton James Harold, Brandon Allen Foudy. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of row 5. Kristen Renee Hawk, Elijah Rand Hawkins, Skylar Marie Hawkins, Summer Lynn Hawkins, Cassidy Leanne Hayes, Courtney Jasmine Helton, Elizabeth N. Helton, Savannah Helton, Shelby Jane Henderson, Destiny Rose Hernandez, Lydia Elise Hernandez, Avery Dawn Hicks, Andrew James Higdon, Dylan James Higdon, Deborah Elizabeth Hall, Kylan Rose Heingartner, Monroe Wyatt Hobbs, Hannah Elizabeth Hoggett, Stella Rose Holiday, Olivia Tatiana Holmes, Devin Michael Horton, Benjamin David Huffman, Bryce Edward Hughes, Levi Hunter. Micah Grace Isham. Samuel Jacob Johnson. Hunter Gene Jones. Kyson Kyrie Jones. Lindsay Ann Jones. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of row 6. Kylie Noelle Colfers, Dilpreet Kaur, Harnoor Kaur, Jashanpreet Kaur, Jasmeet Kaur, Kamalpreet Kaur, Simran Kaur, Mackenzie Jade Hideko Keen, Colin Delaney Key, Jacob David Key, Alexandria Leanne Kindred, Jordan Nicole Knapp, Tatum Simone Knight, Blake Allen Knowles, Brant Andrew Coons, Jeremy E. Kyle, Kennedy Sue Lady, Linda Lamasawney, Alexander Jacob Lambert, Cameron Jamie Land, Justin J. Law, Florence Nabawunaka Lee, Paige Elizabeth Lester, Gavin Matthew Likens, Sarah Ann Lime, Ethan Charles Lohman, Tristan Renee Lopez Cook, Rebecca Joy Lorenz, Giovanni Guest, Chinwen Liu. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of row 7. Reba Noel Lutz, Christopher Robert Lynn, Ariana Grace Madsen, Manreet Kaur Mahal, Mark Braden Malinowski, Drew Genevieve Delichelle Mallory, Tang Leanne Meng, Giselle Mani Passano, Aiden Matthew Mann, Gabriel Logan Wolf Mann, Aris Mardanzai, Colton William Marlin, Kylie Joe Marlin, Caleb Dylan Martin, Avery Michael Martinelli, Xavier Mateer, Ethan Andrew Matthews, Lau Moon Maui, Logan Daniel Mays, Ashlyn Brianna McCammon. Gracie Faith McCorkle. Elijah Michael McCoy. Miles McCreary. Sierra Elaine McMichael. Christian Nathaniel Benwald. Joshua Emmanuel Medina. Taylan May Martin. Luca Duvenjack. Sarah K. Struckman. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of row 8.
Evan Wayne Meese. Grace Nicole Meringer. Elisa Audrey Merrill. Grayson Landon Milam. Ashlyn Elizabeth Miller. Blake Noel Miller. Zoe Alyssa Nicole Miller. Reed T. Moore. Austin Benjamin Morales. Jonathan Andrew Moreno. Alexander Riley Morris. Grace Leanne Motes. Joy Elizabeth Mulhauser. Anna Grace Muir. Emily Grace Murray. Tori Christine Napier. Jade McKenzie Neff. Hunter Austin Shane Newhouse. Hugh Min Nguyen. Kaylee Ann Nguyen. Robinson Kong Nguyen. Jocelyn Alicia Nino. Joseph Russell Novak. Megan Grace Elizabeth Nowacki. Gregory James O'Keefe. Timothy Michael O'Keefe. Jamilex Olivares. Vernon LeJames Oliver. Katya Bakwa Marie Bakwa Olmsted. Zachary Allen Otney. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of row 9. Shelby Lynn Paget. Andrew J. Parker. Daniel Scott Parkhurst. Elijah Paul Parr. Liam Aaron Patterson. Cindy K. Peggy. Erica Renee Persifield. Michael McKinley Perkins. Alexandra Marie Peters. Madeline Marie Phelps. Michael John Powell. Tessa Joy Powers. Kaylin Joyce Prescott. Lily Elizabeth Pryor. Jasmine Quezada. Sydney Esperanza Quiros. Tyreek Seven Radford L. Nicholas Lionel Ramos. Arshnor Singh Randhawa. Taylor Christine Rayner. Emily Ann Reed. Kira Ann Reynolds. Dawson Daniel Richards. Gracie Marie Riggle. Ava Summerlin Reese. Sarah Grace Roberts. Jacob Zachary Roberts. Jordan Tyler Roberts. Evan Caleb Michael Robeson. Eric Gail Rodriguez Gonzalez. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of Row 10. Allison Drew Roll. Ruben Alejandro Romero. Joseph Samuela. Elevenis Marie Ann Sanchez Melton. Garrett Lee Saylor. Lillianne Teresa Schultz. Marty Adriana Scruggs. Zachary Steven Sell. Michaela Angelique Joy Shackelford. Liberty Faith Schaefer. Avery David Sheets. Alexander David Sherfield. Jaskaran Singh Shergill. Kaylin Nicole Sheridan. Aiden Lewis Schatz. Evan Isaiah Silbernagle. Arandeep Singh, Dilpreet Singh, Gaganjot Singh, Gurjot Singh, Harmandeep Singh, Regina Singh, Abigail Lee Smith, Ashlyn Jolie Smith, Emily Marie Smith, Haley Nicole Smith, Jacob Christian Smith, Jacob Edward Smith. Malia Nicole Rose Smith. Nicholas Allen Smith. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of Row 11. Connor David Soltz, Destiny Marie, Gavin Terrell Spaulding, Ashton Riley Spoonamore, Matthew Reed Staley, Christian Alexander Statham, Gage James Lee Steele, Kaya Imogen K. Stegmuller, Noah Durnell Reynold Stinson. Daryl Jean Stevens II. Laney Stevenson. Keyshawn Stewart. Destiny K. Stinson. Wilson Ezra Studdard. Joshua Allen Stumpf. Jillian Rose Sturm. Christian Donovan Sullivan. Maxwell Irvin Sullivan, Ethan James Tanner, Christian Shane Taylor, Ebony Monique Taylor, Hannah Celeste Taylor, Madeline Joy Taylor, Madeline Danielle Jane Taylor, Vincent M. Tarek, Brianna Lynn Turcorn, Trish Trang Tatch, Caden J. Tilson, Kaylee Nicole Tescareno, Arjun Singh Tawana. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of row 12. Matthew Kenneth Trapp, Gabriel Xavier Triplett, Sarah Nicole Turcott, Zoe Ann Usher, Canyon Sky Valentine, Cesar Arturo Vargas Salazar, Gabrielle Marie Vargo, Oswaldo Alexandre Villapando, Jordan Xavier Vincent, Jonathan Wright Wallen, Autumn Renee Walters, Lakeviana Sharon Ward, Abigail Grace Warner, Quinn Thomas Warweg, Trenton Alexander Wayman, Abigail Rose Wenzel, Drew Abigail White, Caden Thatcher Wilburn, Emma Claire Wilcher, Haley Victoria Wilkerson, Gavin Lee Williamson, Isabel Madeline Wilson, Madison Martha Sue Wilson, Nita Evangeline Winsel, Brady James Wire, Gavin Lee Wire, Julian Sky Witherington, Sebastian Aaron Knight Wolf, Brooke Ann Wood, Landon Hunter Wood. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of row 13. Thomas Michael Wright, Zachary Austin Wright, Tristan Stone Yeagy, Bobby Joe Yoler, Catherine Leanne Zajac, and Ruth Zodensongi, Sarah Marie Zwilling, Daniel Saint, Yuvraj Singh Kang. Please join me in congratulating the graduates of row 14.
Class officer, and then you.
Thank you.
As a class officer, I'm honored to lead the senior class of 2022 in the changing of the tassel. This is a very big moment in our lives because we've been working for this for the past 12 years. I know all of us up here are proud to represent you. I would like to congratulate everyone for their hard work and thank the people that allowed us the opportunity to make it this far. To our families, administration, teachers, bus drivers, school resource officers, custodial staff, cafeteria staff, and everyone else that has helped us along the way, we thank you. We would also like to give a special thanks to our principal, Mr. Betts. Thank you, Mr. Betts, for everything you have done for us and everyone at WCHS. Traditionally, the changing of the tassel from right to left signifies graduation and the transition from student to graduate. My fellow seniors, please rise. Seniors, please place your right hand on your tassel. You can move it over. Congratulations, graduates. Please be seated. Now it is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Patrick Spray, Superintendent of Clark Pleasant Community Schools.
As we conclude our program today, I'd like to thank you for your attendance, sharing this experience with our graduates. We ask that you please remain seated until all the graduates have exited the stadium today. Class of 2022, please rise. On behalf of the Clark Pleasant Community School Corporation staff and Board of School Trustees, we congratulate you on your graduation. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the 2022 graduates of Whiteland Community High School.